Their feet are swift to shed blood. Vanessa is healed. And that's why things are happening. Let us not shed blood. Destruction and misery are in their ways. Can you see those people? The old nature. Destruction and misery is in their way. And the way of peace they have not known. There is no fear of God, therefore, before their eyes. There's no fear of God before their eyes. Let me reach there. When we say that the old is gone and we have become new, can you see what the old is supposed to go with? Mm-hmm. We have read from actually verse 10 up to verse 18. The old is supposed to go with this. And other things that the Bible is saying that we do not do. Now, let us continue and notice some things. Righteousness is not just observing the commandments. Hallelujah. Amen. Righteousness is not just observing the commandments, the Ten Commandments and the commandment that Jesus came and summarized. We begin from there, but there's something more than that. We cannot avoid the commands of God. Because by obeying God, we love Him. Amen. But there's something more. Righteousness actually is believing. Because actually it is stamped in the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 6. That the Bible says that, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. Now, let me just say this. Righteousness, apart from obeying the commandments of God, let's seek to please God. In this time of grace and the mercies of God, we only please God by having faith, by believing. Even in the Old Testament, the time of law, we can cite some few examples of people that even their sacrifices were accepted because they gave by faith. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews that by faith Abel offered. And as we read actually the real context in the book of Genesis, we see that Abel and Cain, all of them gave sacrifices, but God accepted whose sacrifice? Abel's. Why? Because Abel gave by faith. Faith opens doors. If you want to move in righteousness and eat the fruit of righteousness, we need to believe and have faith. In who? In Christ Jesus. In our God. Righteousness is actually the opposite of human nature. Surely. As a man, I would wish to do this. And I will always do what profits me. I don't care about others. But at the same time, righteousness is sacrifice. When you are righteous, you can help another person. You can sacrifice and give the coin for tomorrow for another person. I'm giving that as an example because money. And stand for others even in prayer. It's not easy, and that's why at times we feel like we feel not praying even for ourselves. But we need to sacrifice. As righteous people, let us understand that when we are righteous, we are doing the opposite of what our human body, our human nature requires. The opposite. And that's why there is war. Paul said that what I want to do, I don't do it. But what I know I don't want to do is what I do. Kuna fight hapo. Vanessa Sifiwe, righteousness is the opposite of our human nature. In today's world, the world will perish before Christ comes because of unrighteousness. God Himself is righteous. We cannot operate outside righteousness. Vanessa was filled. We need to operate within. We need to swear as God swore in Isaiah that I am going to do God's work in righteousness. We do God's work. with our, sometimes with our intellect, how we can arrange our instruments, how we can put on uniform in choir, how we look while serving God. Okay, we need to be clean and have order, but that should not be our focus. We should do everything in righteousness. The Bible says that all scripture is inspired by God. Let me just take the word inspire. Inspiration is actually involving the Holy Spirit, because even another, in the same scripture, other versions say every scripture is breathed of God, and the breath of God is the Spirit. Now, we have to do everything in line with the Word of God. That's the closest thing with us. We have the Holy Spirit. Some believe, some don't believe that the Holy Spirit is there. But at least we have the Word of God. This should be our friend. And to prove, really, that the Word of God is a weapon we can stand with, the devil has made sure that he wins the battle of drawing this Bible away from us. As righteous people, we have to remember that the devil is there. And when you feel like you don't want to do something, as a righteous person, that is when you need to start. Because if you start, you will flow. The problem is with start. The problem is not with flow. Because even the devil knows that the Word of God is alive and active. So he does not want us to read this life. But when we start, Bwana asifiwe. Let's acknowledge kuwa kuna vita, lakini wacha tuanze kusimama katika nafasi yetu. Stand in our positions, take the Bible, and God will fight with us. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. Now righteousness to a level, we don't have any option but to exercise it. Otherwise we are not Christians that are going to heaven. We are Christians. If we don't do according to righteousness, then we are Christians just like they are Muslims and Hindus. But we don't have any focus. But if we do according to the righteousness of God, we shall go where we're supposed to go. We shall not fear anything. We shall have wisdom. We shall do everything in order, the order of the Holy Spirit. One else was filled. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I hope we are blessed.
Yes.
Somebody write James chapter 2, verses 23. We will not read, but you will read it on your own. The Bible says, and the scripture was fulfilled, which says, Abraham believed God and was accounted to him for righteousness, and he was called a friend of God. Let us take some few examples, some few lessons there. The Bible is not fixated. Some people say that maybe in the New Testament ndio kuna apply righteousness peke yake. Look at these people like Abraham. He believed God and it was accounted in a special way to him righteousness. And he was called a friend of God. We are the generation, literally, by the work of Jesus. We come from Abraham. Abraham, there the lineage of Jesus started from there, as we read in the book of Matthew. Now, if you want to become a friend of God, you are supposed to believe. We become righteous. And in other words, we don't need to cheat ourselves that we are friends of God by not believing. If you don't believe, you are not a friend of God. If you are not righteous, you are not a friend of God. If you are not righteous, you cannot get anything from God. You cannot be given the reward, as we read in the book of Psalms, chapter 18, verse 20. We are rewarded because of righteousness. We can sit in a fellowship Vanessa Sifue, because we have come for a common goal as believers. And let us not die on our own. Let us look for other people and give them what and share with them what we are going through. And of course with caution, because everybody knows who he or she confides in. Let us take note, you share with the person you know. Now, we cannot die by our own. We need to help one another. We are the body of Christ. In righteousness, we need to hold each other's hands. In this walk of righteousness, we need to be to try and be alert to a level of being able to recognize that there's a problem somewhere or there's a change somewhere in a child of God, in God's work here and there. And where it requires prayer, we pray. Where it requires rebuke with love, we do. Where it requires helping, even in advice and counseling, we do. Regardless of what happened yesterday. The devil always comes before something good comes. And if we are able to overcome, we can make good things. Because if somebody, I'm supposed to help today, wronged me yesterday, I'll contemplate whether to help or not help. And most of the time, I will not help. And we are baptized. I'm human. I'm not yet in heaven. So I will not help. And that is why, in one way or another, we are failing as a church. Righteousness is mentioned, like I'm mentioning it many times, but working it out is not just like a simple thing we see. We cannot do it without the help of God. We cannot do it without the help of the Holy Spirit. We cannot do it outside the Word of God. Otherwise, we cheat ourselves. We will make the church move on. We will make things go on and God is not in it. We meet people out there, even in our working places. What does righteousness require of us in our working places? We need to be the light that is on top somewhere, not hidden. Not until somebody pulls out your drawer aone Bible and they say, ala, vile unasomanga tu ama wewe uko born again. Inafaa, a pool na asikuwa surprised. Asema, oh, no wonder. Huyu mtu anatembeanga hivi. Kumbe kuna Bible hapa. Something like that. And it will not come out with the pretense, of course.
Oh, yes.
People will just read. Have you entered a matatu and somebody greets you? Have you seen somebody and he greets you na shuali mjui na hata kujua? People are craving for something. Kuna emptiness in the hearts of people. It requires Russia to minister to them. Even these neighbors we see arrogant. With the ministry we can give them, they can become good people. Just because he wronged you one day, that is not his personality. Some of them were told, ukienda Nairobi, ukalaga chini na mikumbili. Now, ukimpata kwa labda huko up country is a very good person. But it requires a righteous person to tell that person, no, there are some good people here in Nairobi also. People fight with the camper. Okay, we thank God we are blessed here. Most of us live in places where what to see where. But do you know people fight because of these drying lines? Zango. People fight because of water is running on the taps, in the taps. People fight. But a righteous person can even opt to be the last person. I'm giving just an illustration. There are many examples we can give. And by doing something different, you will bring order in that place because of righteousness in you, because of righteousness in me. Drivers, in this church, drivers are very many. But kurushiana mkono kwa roundabout, I was right. Surely you are right. Sababu umeingia kwanza amekuja across. It's true. Sindio? But how do you handle such righteousness on the road? Not as pedestrians, but as drivers. I ask pedestrians to kurushiwa na mnini, just relax. Yours is coming. I don't want to preempt something here. Pastor Wilson. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Righteous people are supposed to live righteous. Everywhere you go, do everything in a righteous way. Watch it ume, but please your God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Hata landlord akikuamkia ama any other person.